Welcome learners, today's topic is hydroelectric power plant. This topic belongs to subject power generation of 8th semester mechanical engineering branch. This is very important topic according to power generation. So let's start from introduction. Hydraulic energy is the cleanest, reliable, efficient and economical of all and renewable energy sources. It has been generated using natural forces such as gravity or flowing water. It is usually produced by dams, as dams can store and direct large amount of water. Hydroelectric power is constantly increasing. India is the seventh largest producer of hydroelectric power in the world. Some country of world like Norway and Switzerland is developed 100% of hydroelectric power. The first hydroelectric power plant was established in India is Sidrapong at Darjeeling and Shiva Samundram at Karnataka. Some another major hydroelectric power plant in India are Tehri Dam, Koyana Hydraulic Power Project, Sardar Sarovar Dam, Bhakra Nangal and many others. Next is the site selections of hydroelectric power plant. Some basic criteria to selections of hydroelectric power plant site. First is the water availability. Main fuel of this plant is water, so such plant should be located nearer to river, canal, etc. where sufficient water is available all the time. Next, water storage. Dam should be located across the river to get continuous water supply throughout the year, especially in the dry season. Next, water head. It is a very important point of the site selections of hydroelectric power plant. Water head is directly related to the cost of generation of electric power. If effective head is increased, water storage has to be reduced, as well as capital cost of the plant is reduced. Next is the distance from the load center. Since it is located away from the load center, more transmission line is required to supply the power. To avoid the line losses and economical power supply, distance of such plant should need more attention. Transportation facility. A good transportation facility must be available to any hydroelectric power plant so that necessary equipment should be reached easily. And next and very important, availability of land. Hydroelectric power plant needs enough space. It should be kept in mind that land should be very cheap. Now next is the main elements of hydroelectric power plant. The main elements of hydroelectric power plant, as discussed below, and the flow sheets of hydroelectric power plant is shown here. This is the basic flow diagram, and this contains the catchment area, reservoir, dams, switch gate, penstroke, inlet wall, turbines, generators and draft tubes. So discuss these all elements one by one. First is the catchment area. The total area behind the dam in which water is collected and stream flow is obtained is known as catchment area. Next is the reservoir. Reservoir, it is an important part of the power plant where water is stored and supplied to the water turbine continuously. Third is the dam. A dam is a barrier which stores water and creates water head. Next is the surge tank. Surge tank is a small tank. It is provided to reduce the pressure surge in the conduits. It is located nearer the beginning of the conduits. Next is the penstocks. Penstocks are open or closed conduits which carry water to the turbines. They are generally made of RCC or steel. Intake or control valves. These are gates built on the inside of the dam. The water from the reservoir is released and controlled through these gates. Next is the water turbine. It works as an energy conversion device. It is a machine through which potential energy of water is converted into mechanical energy of shaft. The main types of water turbines are impulse turbine and reaction turbines. Generator is a device through which electricity is produced. The shaft of the water turbines rotates the generator, which produced alternating current in the coils of the generator. Next, draft tube. A airtight pipes of suitable diameter attached to the runner outlet and conducting water down from the wheel and discharging it under the surface of water in the tail race is known as draft tube. Powerhouses, auxiliaries. The hydroelectric power plant requires the same basic auxiliary as any other power plants, such as governor system, exciters, cranes, control panels, or many more. Power supply of the auxiliaries, cranes, and lighting is usually arranged from a small independent hydraulic turbines and generator. Now, next is the working principle of hydroelectric power plant. Working principle of hydroelectric power plant depends on the conversion of hydraulic energy into electrical energy. To get this hydroelectricity, hydroelectric power plant needs some arrangements for proper working and efficiency. The block diagram of hydroelectric power plant is shown here. Hydroelectric power stations needs huge amount of water at sufficient head all the time. So as hydroelectric dam is constructed across the river or lake, an artificial storage reservoir where water is stored is placed backside of the dam. This reservoir creates sufficient water head. A pressure tunnel is placed in between the reservoirs to valve house, and water is coming from reservoir to penstock through this tunnel. An automatic controlling switch gate is placed in valve house and it controls water flow to the power station, and the latter cuts off supply of water in case the penstock bursted. Penstock is a huge steel pipe in which water is taken from valve house out to turbine. A surge tank is also provided just before the valve house for better regulations of water pressure in the systems. Now, water turbine converts hydraulic energy into mechanical energy, and an alternator which is coupled to the water turbine converts this mechanical energy into electrical energy. So, this is the basic principle of working of hydroelectric power plant. Now, discuss available hydraulic power. The water fall into the water turbine and potential energy of water is converted into electrical energy. This kinetic energy is converted into mechanical energy at the turbine shaft. A hydroelectric generator or alternator is coupled with turbine shaft to convert mechanical energy into electrical energy. The power P is developed by the formula P equals to WQH Nita, and here W is the specific weight of water kg per meter cube, Q rate of flow of water in meter cube per second, h height of fall or head in meters, and eta is the overall efficiency of operations. Now next is the advantage of hydroelectric power plant. So some basic advantage of hydroelectric power plant. First, water source is perennially available, no fuels is required. Running cost is very low as compared to others. No problem of atmospheric pollutions and greenhouse gases emissions. Once a dam is constructed, electricity can be produced at constant rate. Hydraulic turbine can be switched on and off very easily. Hydroelectric power plant is relatively simple in concept and reliable. Operator life expectancy is around 50 years. Can be operate in mixed systems. High efficiency, ancillary benefits like irrigations, flood controls, do not require highly skilled workers. There are also some disadvantages of hydroelectric power plant. The initial cost of the plant is too high. Capital intensive with low rate of return, depends on the amount of water available, far away from the load center, and large hydro plants disturb the ecology of the area. Now next is the classifications of hydroelectric power plant. This is a very important, according to which we can classify all the hydroelectric power plants. So first, according to the extent of water flow regulations, and in this, first is the run of river power plants without pondage. Some hydro plants are so located that water is taken from the river directly and no pondage or storage is possible. Such plant is called run of power plant without pondage. Next is the run of river power plants with pondage. Such power plants are comparatively more reliable and its generating capacity is less, depend on available rate of flow of water. Such power plants can serve as a base load or peak load power plant depending on the flow of stream. And third is the reservoir power plants. When water is stored in a big reservoir behind a dam, it is possible to control the flow of water and use it most effectively. Second classifications according to availability of water head. So also there are three types of hydroelectric power plant: low head, medium head, and high head power plant. Though there is no definite line of segregations for low, medium, and high heads, but the heads below 30 meters is considered low head. The head above 30 meters and below 300 meters is considered as a medium head, and above 300 meters is considered as high head. Next is according to the load supplied. So according to the load supplied, also three types of base load, peak load, and pumped storage plant for the peak load. The plants which can take up load on the base portion of the load curve of the power system are called the base load power system. Such plants are usually of large capacity. Peak load plants used to supply the peak load of the system corresponding to the load at the top portion of the load curve are called the peak load plants. Runoff river plants with pondage can be employed as peak load plants. And third one is the pumped storage plant for a peak load. This is a unique design of peak load plant. So this is the classifications of hydroelectric power plant. Thanks.